Hello, my name's Keith Hawkins. I'm an area horticulture agent with the LSU Ag Center. A couple years ago, during the COVID quarantine, we produced some videos, and one of those videos was about branch angles, the good ones and the poor ones in live trees. Well, we're gonna do something a little bit different. We're gonna look inside parts of trees to see what happens with branch angles. This large specimen here has a V-shaped branch angle. The V-shape is a poor angle. It has the included bark here, very deep. And as this stem and this trunk grows out diametrically, there's pressure on that joint and it will cause splitting. These are hard to find to get these V-shaped branch angles. Usually the tree splits before I can collect one. This is from a pecan, but this is also from a pecan tree. It shows a good branch angle. It's U-shaped right here, and it's got solid wood where bark would be on the V-shaped. And this is a strong branch angle. This is what you want to look for in your trees. This is what you want to keep. If you see a V-shaped branch angle, especially on a small tree, you might want to cut out that offending branch and then the young tree will recuperate. And this is also from a pecan tree. It's a smaller specimen, but it still has that U-shaped branch angle that has solid wood. But it's not just pecan trees. Other species have good and bad branch angles. This is a black cherry tree with a good branch angle. Now, I will admit there is a little bit of included bark, but by and large, this is a very strong branch angle in this tree. From a water oak, and water oaks are infamous for their problems, but even a water oak can have a good branch angle where there's strong wood, making a connection between the branch and the trunk. Now pick this one out, it's a little bit different. It's from a red cedar. It's got good wood attachment, but as it grows out diametrically, this branch is gonna become a loose knot eventually. But what happens in cedar trees is that the tree will self-prune, and this will you wouldn't have to worry about splitting. So again, when you examine your trees, one of the things that you can easily check for are the branch angles. The V-shaped is the ones that are concerning, but the U-shaped branch angles are the branch angles that you really want to have in your trees. And from the LSU Ag Center, I appreciate you letting me visit with you.